7 years ago, the average age of A, B, and C was 51 years. If A is 3 years older than B and B is 3 years older than C, then the present ages of A, B, and C are in years, right? What are the present ages of A, B, and C in years? So there are 2 points basically here, right? First point is that 7 years ago, the average age of A, B, C was 51 years. Now try and understand this. We have discussed in our video on averages as well. If 7 years ago, the average was 51, what is the present average? 51 plus 7, 58. You don't have to spend any time in deciding this, right? 7 years ago, the average of A, B, C was 51. So if you go by the concept of equal distribution, we can say that if 7 years ago, the average was 51, A is 51, B is 51, C is 51. Equal distribution, right? Equal distribution. So which means A, B, and C, all three were 51 years, 7 years ago. Presently, what will happen? If you look at the present scenario, each of A, B, and C will increase by 7 years. If each of A, B, C, and each of A, B, and C have increased by 7 years, average also increases by 7 years. That's a classical law, right? If each value is increased by 7, average increases by 7. So from 7 years ago to the present point, what has happened? All of these A, B, and C have increased by 7. If all have increased by 7, we can say that average is also increased by 7. So what will be the present average? 51 plus 7, 58. Present average will be 51 plus 7, which is 58. Now, average is 58 means what? Sum A plus B plus C. A plus B plus C will be thrice of 58. What is 3 times of 58? 150 plus 24, 174. What's the other thing that is known to us? A is 3 years older than B and B is 3 years older than C. So A is equal to B plus 3 and B is equal to C plus 3. So basically three equations, A plus B plus C equals to 174, B equals to B, A equals to B plus 3, B equals to C plus 3. Three equations in three variables, you can solve and get the answer. However, a smart person will not solve these equations. Equations are correct. I'm not saying the equations are wrong. Equations are correct, but if you are smart, you will not work on these equations. You'll in fact try to work on elimination. Eliminate the wrong answers. See, clearly from the data, we know that A is 3 years older than B and B is 3 years older than C. Which means A has to be greater than B and B has to be greater than C. A is 3 years more than B and B has to be 3 years more than C. In fact, the differences between the two consecutive here has to be 3. Difference between A and B has to be 3. Difference between B and C also has to be 3. Just look at the options that satisfy this condition. See, he's asking us to find out the present ages of A, B, and C. So obviously the order is A, B, C only. So 61 is, yes, 3 more than 58, satisfied. 58 is 3 more than 55, satisfied. So first option satisfies the condition A greater than B greater than C. Also the difference is 3 and 3. 61 minus 58 is 3, 58 minus 55 is 3. So this is a possible answer. Look at option 2, 54 and 51. Yeah, greater, 51 and 48 greater, and both are greater by 3 and 3. 54 is greater than 51 by 3, 51 is greater than 48 by 3. So this also is possible answer. Look at option 3, 55 and 58. A is less than B. 55 is less than 58. Eliminate. Look at option 4. 48 and 51. A is less than B. Is it possible? No. We know that A is greater than B. Option 4 gets eliminated. So the possible answers are option 1 or option 2. Option 1 or option 2. Right? Now, if you look at average, again, how do we go next? What do we do next? We know that the average is 58. Average is 58. That means if I go by equal distribution, if I go by the concept of equal distribution, what happens? A should be equal to, B should be equal to, C should be equal to 58. Average will be 58. If you look at the second set of values, the values given in option 2, A is 54, B is 51, C is 48. All three of them are less than 58. When all A, B, C are less than 58, how can the average be 58? Not possible. A is less than 58, B is less than 58, C also is less than 58. So how can the average value be 58? Not possible. So the only possible answer here is option 1. 60, 61, 58, and 55. You're able to follow? Yes. Simple. So you can solve the equations as well. Solving equations is not difficult. You substitute B equals to C plus 3. Substitute A equals to C plus 3 plus 3. So everything in terms of C, you will get the value of C and you can verify. But why do we have to solve the equations when we can eliminate the options in a smart way, right? 3 and 4 get eliminated because it does not follow this condition. And 2 gets eliminated because it does not follow the average. Hence, option 1 is the answer.